Introduction and Installation. This video tutorial explains how to install the NuVoice Pass software, change the user area to the LAMP Words for Life app, set to the full vocabulary set, and then how to use it to make instructional materials. If you need to install the software, like at home on your personal computer for instance, you will first need to download it. If you're on a school computer, it's likely someone from the IT department who will need to install it. To download the software, go to this website, bit.ly/nuvoiceforallinstall. Then scroll down and press the download button. A window will open asking you where you'd like to save the file. You can save it anywhere you want, but in this example, I saved it to my desktop. After the file downloads, click on it. An installation wizard will start. Follow the instructions to complete the installation. Launching the software and changing the user area. When you are ready to launch the software, find it in your Start menu. Follow the on-screen instructions to launch the software. Go to the toolbox icon and select it. Select the icon again to get into the toolbox. Select User Area Menu. Select Replace User Area Menu. Select any one of the six areas. Select Predefined Areas. Select English. Select LAMP Words for Life. Select the full vocabulary. Type in the word replace and then select OK. You'll be asked if you want to switch to that user area now. Go ahead and do it now. Select OK and you'll be taken to the screen that matches the LAMP Words for Life full user area. This screen is perfect for use on an interactive whiteboard. Creating instructional materials. Go to Vocabulary, Vocabulary Display Options, Write with Icons. Read through the options and make any other necessary changes. Most likely though, the default setting will work. Select OK. Then, go ahead and type your words or phrases. You'll see that the text along with the icon sequence will be displayed. You can save the entire file by going to File, Save. You'll be prompted to select where you'd like to save the document and to give it a name. The document will be saved as a rich text format document, or an RTF. You can then navigate to where the file was saved and open it. The RTF will open in Word with both the text and images. Alternatively, you can copy everything by using the keyboard shortcut of Ctrl-C, opening Word, and then pasting it in using the keyboard shortcut Ctrl-V. The icons then act like any other image in a Word document. Finally, save the document if you'd like. Now you have a Word document with the icon sequences that you can use for instructional purposes.